All right, you ready to do this live?
Do it.
Hit it, Josh. Oh, goodness, this feels good. Heaven, I'm in heaven. And my heart beats so that I can hardly speak. And I seem to find the happiness I seek when we're out together dancing cheek to cheek.
Heaven, I'm in heaven. And the cares that hung around me through the week seem to vanish like a gambler's lucky streak. When we're out together dancing cheek to cheek. Oh, I love to climb a mountain and to reach the highest peak. But it doesn't thrill me half as much as dancing cheek to cheek. Oh, I love to go out fishing in a river or a creek. But I don't enjoy it half as much as dancing cheek to cheek.
Come on and dance with me. I want my arms about you.
The charms about you will carry me through to
heaven. I'm in heaven. And my heart beats so that I can hardly speak.
And I seem to find the happiness I seek. When we're out together dancing cheek to cheek. Come on and dance with me. I want my arms about you.
The charms about you will carry me through to
heaven. I'm in heaven. And my heart beats so that I can hardly speak.
And I seem to find the happiness I seek.
When we're out together dancing.
Dancing and romancing.
We're out together dancing cheek to cheek.
Thank you, Josh.
Thank you, Josh. Woo! Watch with Glenn Wilson, everybody.
Tonight on Live with Cordone and Kilgore.
From One Voice, the music of Barry Manilow, friend and entertainer extraordinaire Mark Sanders joins us for a chat and a song.
Right now on Live with Cordone and Kilgore.
Oh, welcome everyone to Live with Cordone and Kilgore. Thank you for joining us. I'm Natalie Cordone.
And I am Sean Kilgore. We are thrilled that you are here this evening. Thank you. Like Natalie said, so much for joining us tonight. Today is Thursday, April 15th. We're breaking outside of the norm here a little bit. We usually come to you on Monday nights. Here it is, Thursday, April 15th. We thought it was going to be tax day.
It is every year, except this year.
But we got a great show lined up for you today. We hope you all have had a great week. This is episode 13 of Live with Cordone and Kilgore with our very special guest, Barry Manilow tribute artist, Mark Sanders.
We are streaming to you live on our Facebook and YouTube pages. And now again with our brand new Twitch page. And you can find us on all these pages through the magic of StreamYard. Now, if you're joining us tonight on Facebook, please invite your friends to join us. It's really simple. You can just click on that button down at the bottom. And you can also share if you're on Instagram and you want to find us on the Instagram. We're also on there. And if you haven't yet, please make sure that you've liked our page. Cordone and Kilgore. And you can keep up with us on the latest Cordone and Kilgore news also through our website.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Yep. And if you're joining us on YouTube, we'd appreciate it if you would subscribe to our channel if you haven't already done so and like this video. That would be great. We appreciate that. And no matter where you're joining us from, please, as always, comment, participate in the chat. We love to be as interactive as possible, and we're going to get to as many of your comments as we possibly can as we go throughout our time together this evening.
Yeah, so if you have any questions for Mark, our guest this week, or if you have any questions for us, if we haven't been open books enough, you're always welcome to ask them. And to find out where we're going to be next, you can always ask us that as well. So our next gig, as we keep pushing for all of you, is a free live event. If you live outside of Oshkosh, Wisconsin, on June the 11th, you can find us at the Grand Oshkosh in Wisconsin, where we're going to be doing a live stream of our Steve and Edie show. And we are thrilled that we're going to get to bring it to all of you free and live. So if you want to join us on a live stream, we would be happy to have you there.
Absolutely. Yeah. Visit the Grand Ash, the grandoshkosh.org, as you see scrolling across the bottom of your screen there to set up your,
that good singing.
Yes, exactly. Just loosened it all up. to get your link for that live stream. It's going to be a great live stream. We're very excited to be able to reach an even broader audience, yeah. With this live stream that will be free once again. And you can learn a little bit about the history of Steve Lawrence and Edie Gourmet if you don't already know who they are.
Yeah. So for those of you who aren't Steve and Edie fans but are Cordone and Kilgore fans, we're glad that you're here. And we are always looking for good things that have happened in the world. So if you have guests that are friends of yours or people who you think bring good news out into the world and you'd like us to share that with all the rest of you, please do feel free to, you can DM us on Facebook or you can always email us at CordoneKilgoreLive@gmail.com because we want to hear all about your friends that are doing good things because we're all about accentuating the positive.
That's right. And speaking of accentuating the positive, we're going to do a little mixology, right?
Okay. So I'm going out on a limb here this week because I am far from a mixologist, but I was so inspired by our time with Wade and Mike over at the distillery
Archetype,
that we are now bringing out the Archangel Vodka. So we used their gin when we did the gin fizzes, but I'm going to try to make my favorite drink, which I've actually never made at home. But we're going to try and see if I can do it live on the air. That's always a really good, a good reason, a good way to try something.
So tell us what you're doing
in front of a bunch of people. So I am bringing out some limes that I pre-cut. That was our PAs in the back. They pre-cut the limes. And all you do is you take your muddler and you're going to muddle the lime. Sean, you want to muddle the lime? I say that because he's the big strong man.
As he cracks
the glass and we figure out how easy it is.
How do you muddle? Is it just twist.
Okay. Yeah. So you're going to so this is a vodka-based drink, obviously, and it has the simplest ingredients in the world. Now, if you ask for it by name, it is a Kapiroska, which to me sounds very Russian, right? Like a Kapiroska.
Yeah, yeah.
It's Brazilian, and we learned about it from a friend who then we found out in Cancun. They're like totally normal, and you can find them on lots of menus down there.
Totally normal.
It's like,
how do I know when it's muddled enough?
I think you're good. Mm-hmm. Here, do the other one.
Okay.
So, because Sean has to have one too. So a muddled lime is just a squished up lime in a glass.
Squish it.
That's my technical.
Squish it real
my
good.
My technical term for it.
Squish
it good. And then this was actually the simple syrup that we made from that same video that we did with Archetype. So you're going to put a little simple sugar in there too. So you ready for your simple sugar?
Yep.
So just pour a little tiny bit of that in there. So far we have sugar, lime. Now, the most important part is coming, but I just realized that I left my ice on the floor. So you're going to do this over ice. Sean, are you ready for over the ice?
Yep.
Okay. So
you tell me what to do.
You're going to take the tongs and grab some ice.
Okay.
It's going to be really difficult. Ready? Two or three ice cubes, four or five ice cubes, whatever floats your boat. Okay.
How many would you like?
I'll take the same, whatever you did, samesies. That looks good.
Yeah.
That looks really good. Okay.
Right.
And then, most importantly, you take your excellent vodka.
Is that all that's in it? Is then just now the vodka?
This is literally it.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wow.
It's a super clean, as far as, alcohol goes, it's a super clean drink. And the best part about it is that it's really all about the bartender. Like, it's really all about the mixologist.
The pour. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yep, that's it. then you're going to, you know what? I'm not going to put this over by the electronic equipment.
Yeah, that's
so you're going to, yeah, just like stir it up a little bit and
stir it. Should I stir it with the muddler?
You can stir it with the muddler if you want. I'm just going to give it a little. I didn't bring a cocktail straw.
Okay.
So I'll take these. And now we're just going to cheers to episode 13. Ready?
Here we go.
Okay, let's see if it's any good. If it's not, it's Sean's fault.
I have to say, ooh, that is like strong, some of the smoothest vodka I've ever
had. It's really excellent.
I mean, for it to really only be vodka and lime juice, it's like...
Correct.
It's not bitey. It's really, I mean, it's...
And the best part is it's not like, we're not getting paid. Like, we're not... Yeah, in any way...
Well, we got bottles, but...
We did, yeah. But I mean, we're just... It's just spectacular. But you can do it with... We used to do Tito's or Grey Goose, or whatever your favorite vodka is. To have at home.
Yeah.
And if you have a favorite drink, so again, Cappy Rosca, you can look it up. If you tell a bartender that this is what you want and they know what you're talking about, they are like the world's most, like the best versed bartender on the planet, because it's kind of a weird drink to
I
know.
Enjoy it.
So yeah, but it's a good drink. So if you have a favorite drink that you love, actually, can they put it in the chat?
Yeah.
And everybody, if you have a favorite drink that we should try out and about, if we're getting back out
that's
and about.
That's a great idea.
Or if you want us to try making them here on the air,
we
picked the simplest drink that I knew, other than like pouring wine out of a bottle.
Here, which crush up the lime and pour some vodka.
Exactly,
over.
Yeah, and put some sugar in there. But if you do have a favorite drink that you love, we would love to hear about it. So
yes, absolutely.
Yeah.
Is this okay on this table? Or do you need a
cup? Yeah, no, you're fine. Go okay. for it. Yeah. All right. So we are coming to you live this week from my house because we were at Sean's house last week. And so we are very, very, very grateful to Joshua Glenn Wilson for joining us, who was obviously on the piano before. He is our music director and a great love of ours and also a wonderful pianist. So thank you, Josh, for being here.
Absolutely. Let's say hi to some
people. Oh, yeah. Let's say hi to some people. Oh, hi, Mommy.
Mama. John Peterson here. John Ooh. Peterson, one of our guests from last
yes,
week.
Who if had you saw. Amazing debut last week.
Yes.
Funny Bones, if you didn't get a chance to see it, was so fun.
It's
I got
great.
To catch the late show. It was awesome.
It is actually available on demand through
yes!
April 30th. So go to p3theater.biz. We got an excellent review of the show. So it really it really went well for us. And so hey Johnny, thanks
so
for being
John.
Here.
So hi John. Say hi to Rita for us and congratulations.
Yep. I got my mom here.
Oh,
let's just
hi,
say.
Mom. Oh,
you look great. We look great.
Aw, thanks.
Very good. My sister is
hey,
here.
Hey, everybody.
Hello, Drew's
hello.
Here.
Oh, hey, Drew. Oh, I'm so glad you're here. He's another wonderful pianist who's a friend yeah. of ours. We've got a lot of very talented
some
friends.
Applause. Gloria Rice is
oh,
here.
Oh, hi, Gloria Rice. Speaking of talented folks.
Yeah.
Singer.
Our friend from Istanbul
Springer.
Is here.
Yes.
Can you read?
Yes. A great duo. Haven't. Nope. Oh, heaven has descended to Istanbul too. Well sung, you guys. Greetings from Istanbul. That's amazing. We're so glad you come back week after
yeah,
week.
Yeah, that's so nice.
That's exciting for us.
I have Faith here.
So thank
also.
You. Yes. Faith. Hey, Faith.
Whoops.
Yep. Yeah.
And my friend Dawn is here. Awesome. Very nice.
Oh, thank you guys
Excellent.
For coming.
Thank you everyone for being
Ooh,
here.
Ooh, and I hear that your mom has some good suggestions for drinks there if you want to take a look.
Does she?
Yes. So
I'm sorry,
Long
I got
Island
a little
Ice,
closer here.
I'm lucky. I'm the young one, so I've still got the good eyes. So Long Island iced tea for Dad and a pina colada.
I would love
mom.
To see the show where we make Long Island iced teas.
Let's do it. I don't have all the ingredients, so we're going to have to go
It'll
somewhere
It'll be
else.
Our first two-hour show that will just descend
It'll be 4 hours.
Into madness.
Yeah, it'll just be terrible. That's maybe we should do another Russian roulette and with the Long Island iced teas like we did before. So we did a Facebook Live
yeah.
where all we did was just go through whatever tracks we happened to find, like on Spotify, to see if we knew these songs, and some of them went better than others. if you want to go check it out, it's
I should
Facebook
put together.
Page.
Yeah, there's some. I got some a blooper
oh,
reel
it's
from
not
that.
Great.
So normally we do a good news segment where
yeah.
we talk a little about the good news. I do have a little thing
Ooh.
That I want to share, though. My
oh, yes,
sister
please.
And her family decided to go on a little vacation. They all
Ooh.
Got vaccinated, so they're like, let's get out, get out of the house, get on, go on a road trip. And it turned into like a Griswold family vacation. They
oh,
got a flat
no.
tire. Like,
oh,
it was
no.
like one thing after another. But when they got the flat tire, they were struggling with it. My 14-year-old niece actually got down there and started, trying
wow.
to change. They like talked her through changing the tire because it was, difficult for them to do. And a good Samaritan stranger came by and said, "Hey, you guys need some help." And at first, they were like, my niece was like, "No, I think I got it.
Aww.
And the guy's like, "Let me help you. Let me help you." And he, you know, he came in and he helped them change their tire. And they were, you know, of course, very appreciative, tried to thank him. They wanted to, you know, to give him some cash or something. And what the man said to them was he refused the cash. And he said, just pay it forward. He said, when you come across someone else in need, help them.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Well, and your sister's been doing that the whole time anyway. Well, yeah, so this was, she had already paid it forward and she was just getting paid back by her little angel that came to her guardian angel. That's lovely. I love that story. Thanks for sharing some good news.
Cool. What happened in your week? Anything?
I didn't have anything that was quite that miraculous happen this week, but things have been good. We've been busy and again, getting things ready to go up to Oshkosh and feeling good about booking tickets to go up there and getting the band back together. We have a rehearsal schedule now, which makes me feel wonderful.
Yeah, so that's exciting to have rehearsals on the books.
On the books, and the fact that we're back together singing, I just can't imagine anything going more right in 2021.
Amen to that. Yeah, things are moving forward, and let us all move forward in good health.
Absolutely. So speaking of great shows and great next steps, we have an amazing guest. It's coming on the show.
Yeah, we're very excited about our guest today.
So, but
in addition to this great show that we have lined up for you tonight, we want you to know real quick that next week we're taking the week off and we will be back with you on Monday.
April 26th.
Thank you. We'll be back with you Monday, April 26th, when we welcome from the Experience of the Soul podcast, Reverend Cynthia Alice Anderson and our friend Dave Kropp, who will be joining us. We'll be talking about the importance and the good effects of meditation. And they have a really successful podcast channel with has a bunch of different shows, one that's actually geared towards singers as well. So we're excited about that. That's going to be coming up again. So next week, again, we're off.
Taking a week off.
April 26th, Monday, we'll be back with you with that show.
Yeah. But before we get to that, we want to get to tonight's show where we have Mark Sanders joining us. He grew up in Marion, Illinois, and has appeared in theatrical productions and concerts all over the world. Mark was seen as Perchik on the Broadway National Tour.
I did that role. Not on the Broadway National Tour.
No, but you guys have lots. You guys have lots in common, actually. Yeah. You both have great jackets.
It's true.
You are good costumers. I'm just saying. And he's also become a favorite soloist with the Gulf Coast Symphony. His show, One Voice, The Music of Barry Manilow, will begin touring again in 2021 with a brand new CD of Manilow's incredible music. We would like to welcome Mark Sanders.
Hello.
Yay!
Hello, everybody.
Hey, welcome. Thanks for being here.
An honor to be with you. It's good to see your faces.
Good to see your face too. We got so used to seeing you every so often at those conferences. It's been weird to not be running into you.
I know, that's true. That's very true. I miss that, but it's coming. We're going to do it again.
It's coming. It's right around the corner. But you have some exciting stuff going on. So before we get into your Barry Manilow tribute show and all of that, you have a very diverse background. You have interests that go way beyond that, right?
For sure.
So you're a carpenter, right?
Yeah. I went to college for marketing and graphic design.
Okay.
And so obviously you fell into carpentry.
Art class. And so when I was in New York, I didn't want to, wait tables. I just kind of wanted to have my own little business, and word of mouth got out. I did the window front for a store called Delphinium Cards and Gifts, which is still there on 47th Street. And nice. I lived on 46th. It was very easy. And I started doing carpentry, and then I just learned how to do it as we went, and word got out. And then, you know, I ended up on HGTV and did for an episode of Mission Organization. And then,
tell us a little bit more about that.
What's that?
Tell us a little bit more about that. So, how did that come about? How did that happen for you?
Well, actually, I did Miss Saigon at Pittsburgh CLO, and Randy Ballesteros was one of the actors in that, and he was one of the hosts for Mission Organization, and they were doing a show in New York City, and he called me up and said, hey, are you still doing carpentry? Because that show doesn't really have a carpenter per se, but they needed a banquette built. So I said sure. So I ended up being on the show and built the banquette and helped them paint
What's a bankette? I don't even know. For those of us who don't know, what's a bankette?
A bankette is, it's just, it's along the wall. It was basically a seating system with storage underneath, and then the table is
here.
So it's usually, which is Good question. Yeah, like you do. Like
I'm sure there's got to be somebody else out there.
I'm sure. Like, do they have baguettes in Istanbul?
Like,
I don't know.
It's not Russian, but it could be British.
That's right. It could be.
Excellent. Yeah. Well, that's very cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. I love the fact that you do have such a diverse background, that you've done so many things.
I've done a few different things here and there. So,
while you were doing those things, while you were being a carpenter and while you were doing your graphic design, were you also performing at that time?
Well, I was, it was when I was in New York that I started doing some carpentry. I actually, the first apartment that I had, my friend Todd Howell and I had a big backyard that had a deck. It was on 46th Street. And so it was rotten underneath. So I lifted it and built it back, put it back down and rebuilt it. And then work got out. So that was in New York. I started carpentry work. And so I was using my graphic design skills, my attention to detail. Everything's an art project for me. So everything that I look, you know, so I like the detail of it all. So, and then I learned along the way. I would either watch HGTV back in the day when Trading Spaces was happening. And
I loved that show.
I ended up doing Sound of Music with Paige Davis, actually. It was
amazing.
Yeah, at CLO. So, you know, and then I just created my own stuff, and word gets out, and then you learn how to build stuff, whether it's an entertainment unit, whether it's doing a little bit of electrical work, but finding out how to do it correctly. So, so that's,
well, I have an old wooden deck I'd like you to take a look at.
he's already ready to give you some work. Well, speaking of entertainment, you see how I'm going to try to do this? Speaking of entertainment systems, you are quite the entertainer.
I know.
So how did you, it's the Cappy Rosca at work. So speaking of great entertainers, how did you come to Barry Manilow? Like, where did you go? Have you always been a huge fan, or how did this come about?
Fanilow?
Oh my.
Not officially until, but it started back in 78 when I was at my cousin's house. She's the one that was a huge fan low back then. And I heard, even now for the very first time, of really sitting down and listening to Barry Manilow. Little did we know, we knew some of Barry's stuff, whether it's commercials and other stuff, but it was a 78. And then I've loved his stuff throughout, but then I did a 15-minute medley with the Naples Concert Band about 4 or 5 years ago. And what that did to the audience and brought them to their feet, because they all knew it and sang along. And I got a wave in, you know, during Daybreak and things like that. And I was just whoa, to see what effect Manilow's music has on people, including myself. But I didn't realize. And that's when I had Phil Hinton do some stuff for my solo concerts, and then Lisa Rock came into the picture, and then that's my agent. So and that's right. Where the whole Manilow world came for me. One voice.
That's excellent. We actually share. So for those who don't know, Lisa Rock Entertainment is we share her as an agent. We're both represented by her.
Yeah, she's a wonderful manager, and we can't wait to get back out on the road with her.
Yeah.
But when you were going from doing that medley and feeling like you really could connect to the audience that way, how did you go from that to creating a whole show? Because your entire show, One Voice, is all Barry Manilow's music, right?
Right, exactly. Well, when I moved to Florida from New York City back in 2009, I started doing concerts and putting stuff together. I got the chance to do so. Never in my wildest dreams did I think that I would be singing with the symphony or creating my own shows. And so 10 years later, as I had been building a lot of them, when I did meet with Lisa in New York and she wanted to work with me, we went through, she's like, okay, what do you do? You got your Broadway, I've got my standards. I said, you know what? I did this 15-minute medley of Manilow. And she's like, you know what you need to do? I said, I need to do a Manilow show. So that's when my wheel started turning and really started putting songs together and stories. And I'm not an impersonator. I say that at the top of my show.
Absolutely.
I do not impersonate Barry Manilow. Some people think that it's like, well, he doesn't sound a thing like
Margaret.
But it's one of those things that I loved his stuff, and we all have stories. And so I weave some of my own personal stories with it, and a little bit of Bearpedia, I call it, you know, some of the, just the stories of the songs, whether it's Mandy or I Write the Songs. This is who really wrote I Write the Songs and who recorded it first, but it was Manilow. You know, it was Bruce Johnson of the Beach Boys that a lot of people don't realize. And to hear that Manilow didn't really want to sing I Write the Songs because of what people would think. So to hear stories left and right, and I hear them now when I do the concert, I hear it from people who have met him or have been around him or know people who, and to hear those stories, and I'm excited to hear more of those. So that's kind of how One Voice came about.
Excellent. And yeah, that's the best. We've experienced something, you know, very similar things with Steve and Edie in that, you know, we did a bunch of research, but the stories that you get from people who knew them or who were connected or who saw them that you can't find on the internet, those stories are truly priceless, and that you get to, you know, then weave those into your show and to make that part of the story that you tell, I think is really an awesome thing.
Yeah, we've had lots of Steve and Edie's relatives come to the show over the years, and that's been really special to get to know those sort of private stories that they've been willing to share with us that were personal enough that it makes us feel like we get to know them just a little bit better. And I know that you're experiencing that same thing on the road. But speaking of you guys having, go ahead.
No, I was just saying, even the first person I called was my friend Jenny Hacker, who she's like, oh my gosh, I'm a huge Barry Manilow fan, and her husband's a trumpet player. She's like, well, you know, Jim played with him every time he came to Florida. And I'm like, what?
So, crazy, right?
You know, and then more and more, I had my violinist who's on my CD. Not violinist, harpist, good heavens. Dickie Fleischer, he's like, yeah, when Manilow came down, you know, I always played with him. So I have all these little things, the buckets of people that I'm like, who knew I was so close to Barry? So of the people that I knew, so it's exciting. Go ahead.
Well, and you mentioned Paige, working with Paige Davis earlier. You actually have worked with quite a few big names in the business. Can you tell us a little bit about some of the other people that you've been had the privilege to work with?
Gosh, well, you know, for anything from Adrian Barbeau, we did filler at Pittsburgh, most of them at Pittsburgh, to Sutton Foster, to Stephanie J. Block, and I go way back. But probably the biggest would be Jeff Goldblum. We did the Music Man. It was Jeff Goldblum, Ileana Douglas, Ed Begley Jr.
Jeff Goldblum as Harold Hill?
As Harold Hill.
Wow. And, I cannot actually imagine that. Filmed
you got trouble right here. Was that how it was?
He did all the Jeff Goldblum isms, you know, but he mumbled a lot of that. And of course, who's the first one? You know, there's like trouble in the background. I'm like, trouble. So who's the first one that, you know, in performance that did it out loud, you know, because I thought he said the Q word. I'm like, trouble. And he wasn't there.
And you're like, you're the only one.
Just you. Oh my gosh. You were the trouble.
That is awesome.
But it was great. It was a great experience. They actually filmed it. It was supposed to be a documentary, but it ended up being a mockumentary. It's called Pittsburgh. So check it out.
So we'll definitely be looking that up.
Cannot wait to see that. Yes. So Joe Furlow, who is the grand poobah of the grand Oshkosh, who's bringing us in to do the Steve and Edie show, is here. And he said, I had a fender bender once taking an extra lap around the block to listen, sing to Looks Like We Made It. My father never let me forget it and told me to stick with that. The other guy, what is it? Oh, to stick with the other guy, Billy Joel. That's really funny. Oh, that's a really good story. I love that.
That is great.
Again, you just can't get these things unless you put it out there that you're a big fan of whoever your tribute is.
Dustin wants to know, are you in that Pittsburgh documentary? Do we see you in that?
I am.
Yes!
A lot. So once we found out it was a mockumentary, some of them were like, wait, what? I thought it was a documentary. But it's a really, really funny movie.
That's awesome.
Yeah, I will definitely be looking at
that
for sure.
Yeah, me too. I'm just picturing Christopher Guest all over the place. Yeah. Mighty Wind Part 2.
So tell us.
Every time, because I did the, he's a music man. He's a music man, the big thing at the beginning. And I sat next to Jeff in the opening number in that train sequence. And the first time I ever did it for the dress run or for the designer run, I screwed up the words. And when you screw up the words on that, you're lost. And so right before every time I would almost, it was time to my, for me to get up and say that, Jeff would go, uh-oh, here comes. Uh-oh, look out.
That's not very nice.
And then afterwards he'd be like, I was there the whole time. I didn't even know what's going on. These people are in the I'm like, what is that, Jeff? What is that? I was there the whole time. Oh, the inner monologue. Okay.
Oh my gosh. That is great.
It's hysterical. That's really funny.
I love that story. That is
awesome.
Oh
my goodness.
Let's see. What do we have here? Can you?
Yeah. So our friend from Istanbul says Manilow's Could It Be Magic is based on a Chopin piece. I didn't know that.
Yes, you didn't.
Did you know that, Mark? I didn't know that.
I did. It's Chopin's. Oh, gosh. Now I'm going to like forget it. Chopin in C minor, Opus 28, number 20. I do believe it is. Sounds like a.
Yes, I think that sounds like a great answer.
Yeah, we're going to go with that.
We're definitely going to go with that. I think that's a great idea.
So tell us what you have things in common with Barry Manilow.
I do. You know, when I first sang with the symphony, I was with Lisa Vroman. And she would come out. She'd change dresses all the time. And the audience would go bananas. I was like, oh, no.
Who would
no.
do that? So,
exactly. I don't know.
Yes, it's a good trick. Crazy.
So I'm like, oh, I see how this is going to work. So I started collecting jackets and velvet to rhinestoning my own snowflake jacket for the Christmas stuff I did with the symphony. And then as Manilow came into my life, if you will, when I went out to see him in Vegas, I took some pictures and I was just like, I fell in love with one of these jackets that he had. And he, of course, he changes jackets all the time. So, and there it is.
And this
that
one
is
here,
the
yeah.
That I took. And,
oh, no way.
That I
you had good seats.
And then, well, you
and
know,
a good camera.
How many times did you Barry Manilow that you're about to do a show? So I'm like, I'm going to pay for the good seats. So,
yeah, right?
Yeah. And then when I got home, I was creating, as I was creating the show, I have a friend who owns the Tux place. Here, black tie tuxedo, and she hooked me up with some jackets. And then, as a graphic designer, like I do, and a carpenter, so using all those skills, I created, recreated that his jacket. It's not silk, but those are Swarovski crystals. So, in the upper left there, yeah, that's all hand drawn into that, and I started putting them together, see what they look like. Made the stencils and put this disappearing ink on there. And then you see the finished jacket on the right. So all those are
really incredible
that I bought on. And so, yeah.
And you do it all. You do it all.
It's a lot of
incredible.
Fun, so I have to stop myself because the crystals cost more than the jackets do. But but you know, I
understand the need for more rhinestones on stage. I feel like if there were anyone who was going to understand your plight of not feeling quite sparkly enough and needing to add.
Yeah.
That would be me. So I'm with you.
I try to pull back and not have them on all the jackets. They're only on the first couple for now. And then, you know.
Nice. So fun. Tell us about, just like us, you know, we love our band. We have been traveling with the same guys for years. And the same is true for you, right? So tell us a little bit about the guys that you work with.
Yeah, I couldn't have asked for the gods to thank me and throw down these guys, put them in my life. I was doing a show on the other card. There they are. Yes, we have. I met Phil Hinton, my music director. He's on the left there, doing a concert. He was a fill-in for the piano player who had moved away. And they said, well, be careful. He doesn't play exactly what's on the page. I'm like, okay. And I came out and he was playing everything. I didn't know what he was playing. I was doing This Is the Moment. And I remember walking up, and when I got about 3 feet from the microphone, he went into it. Bum, 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 bum. And I was like, oh, that was good. And I have never sung that song quite as easily and with someone who is a true accompanist. And then I find out, I'm like, who are you? And then you get to know him. And then you're like, oh, you were an orchestrator for the BBC and did arrangements for and played with, like, Shirley Bassey and Andrew Lloyd Webber and Paul McCartney, and toured as the music director for Anthony Newley and so many others. And he's in Lauderdale here. And so I'm
not to mention he's an awesome guy. I've been very blessed to work with Phil on many projects over the past 30 years probably. He worked on Laughing Matters with us, and he just music directed Funny Bones, the show that is currently available on demand through April 30th.
And that's right. That John Peterson was a part of. So thanks for being here.
So speaking of singing, we would love if you would grace us with a little Barry Manilow tune. Not a little one. Probably the big one.
The big one.
When you watch your show, you're waiting for this song. I mean, I love all of the songs, but I'm always like, I'm so excited for this one.
It's time. So like, it's
let's
time.
Get right to it. Get right to it. So ladies and gentlemen, please give a nice warm welcome, as it were, virtual welcome to Mark Sanders.
Hey, come on. All right, you gotta do this song, right? All right, now everybody get up and dance around wherever you are, because I can see you. I can see y'all. All right, Drew, I know you want to do this. Her name is Lola. She was a showgirl with yellow feathers in her hair and a dress cut down to there. She would merengue and do the cha-cha. And while she tried to be a star, Tony always tended bar across the crowded floor. They worked from 8 till 4. They were young and they had each other. Who could ask for more? At the Copacabana, the hottest spot north of Havana. At the Copacabana, music and passion were always the fashion at the Copa. They fell in love. His name was Rico. He wore a diamond. He was escorted to his chair. He saw Lola dance there, and when she finished, he called her over. But Rico went a bit too far. Tony sailed across the bar, and then the punches flew, and chairs were smashed in two. There was blood in a single gunshot, but just who shot who? At the Copacabana, the hottest spot north of Havana. At the Copacabana, music and passion were always the fashion at the Copa. She lost her love. All right, come on with me. Copa, Copacabana, like in Havana, music and passion, always in fashion. Come on, dance it out. Do you bring gays and cha-chas? You can't see it. Use the hips. Her name is Lola. She was a showgirl, but that was many years ago. And they used to have a show. Now it's a disco, but not for Lola. Still in the dress she used to wear, faded feathers in her hair. She sees they're so refined and drinks herself half blind. She lost her youth and she lost her Tony. Now she's lost her mind. At the Copacabana, the hottest spot north of Havana. At the Copacabana, music and passion were always the fashion at the Copa. Don't fall in love. Come on, sing it with me. Copa, Copacabana, like in Havana, music and passion, always in fashion. At the Copacabana, don't fall in love.
Yeah.
Woo-hoo! Yeah. Love it, Kathy. Loves it. Thank you, Drew. Y'all dancing around. You almost threw out your hair.
Yes, she does. Oh, Kathy loves it.
I just threw out my hip.
Yes, John. He takes direction well. What can we say?
Exactly. Oh, my God.
Yes.
That was awesome. Thank you so much. Absolutely loved it.
Yeah.
A shout out to the rest of my band, too. Because Phil totally, I said, who's your number ones? And I'm like, You know, we've got, you know, Frank Derrick, Rancis Colon, Phil Fest, and Elijah Gee is not in that picture. He's got second keys. But it's, you know, people have worked with Ricky Martin and Placido Domingo to freaking the David Letterman show drummer, Frank Derrick, on NBC. Wow. I'm like, what happened? So shout out to them. They were playing on that track. So
awesome. Awesome. All right. So tell us real quick. So you had, tell us about the CD real quick that you have available.
Well, the CD, in the pandemic, aside from repainting my house and doing all the carpentry work around my house I could finally do, I knew that I needed to finally put the CD together for One Voice. And in August, I had the band come over. It was one day. They had the charts already, so they just laid down everything. And since then, I've been at the studio here in Fort Myers with my producer, Julian Sundeby. And we laid down the tracks. Phil and I did a new version of I Am Your Child and did a video with that. And hopefully the CD will be coming out, hopefully in May, we're looking at. But they're mixing it. And I'm designing the cover and the jacket and all that stuff. So
excellent.
If you go to marksandersonevoice.com, you'll see the cover of it there. And hopefully I'll get some pre-orders out soon. And so
excellent.
So look for it. Look for me.
So we are running out of time, but we ask, we were wondering if, sorry, these are, Natalie makes good drinks. if you'd stick around for just a few more minutes to play a little getting to know you.
Yeah, I would love that. So each week we like to take a moment to get to know our guests and our audience, of course, a little bit better. So this segment is, of course, getting to know you. It's a series of questions that we randomly pick from a deck of cards called Poddex. Now, our first official sponsor of the show is Poddex, and we would like to take the time for getting to know you.
Yeah. This edition of Getting to Know You is powered by Poddex, the hottest new tool for podcasters and can make for a fun night at home, too. Simply shuffle up, ask a question, and let the good times roll. Check out poddex.com and use code GOODVIBES for 10% off your order.
I have no idea what's happening.
All right, so let's give me one second here. I'm going to make my speakers here, so because Natalie lost your ear. So can you talk, Mark, for a second?
Oh, yes, I can talk.
Oh, fantastic. Oh, thank you. I couldn't hear the very, very end of the last section, so I appreciate you going without me there. But we're here for the Poddex segment, yes. And we are ready to have you and all of our audience members get to know each other.
All right, everybody. Chat fired up. So everybody out there watching, throw your answers up there in the chat. Let's all play along. Let's all get to know each other. So question number one is, when you were a kid, did you have any posters on your wall? And if so, what were they?
I 100% did. Oh boy, did I. Yes. Okay, so I had two on my door, and they were both those posters where if you moved, like, it looked like the eyes were following you.
Oh wow.
Yeah, you know, like, I don't know, it was the way they took the photo. I don't know what the deal was. But one was Michael J. Fox, because he was super hot back then. And the other one was Candace Cameron's brother.
Kirk Cameron.
Yeah.
I was jealous of my sister's Kirk Cameron posters.
Yeah. So they were both on my door. You can only see it when the door was open. They were on, like, the outside of the door. So those were my two posters. Nice. How about you, Mark? Who'd you have on the wall?
Oh yes. Oh my gosh. Well, I actually did have the iconic Farrah Fawcett. I was a huge fan, but
with the wings and the nips,
the whole thing. And and I had been looking for that. I've been looking for that because that is now worth probably a lot of money if it's not.
Oh my gosh, no kidding.
So yes. I can't find that anymore. I had Star Wars stuff.
Oh, that's good. Yeah. I like the Farrah Fawcett poster though. That's iconic.
Well that's iconic. It's an iconic thing. How can you not? And of course, back when Tiger Beat and all that stuff was going, you know, I had some
Tiger Beat.
Yes, speaking of Tiger Beat, my aunt just put in a comment that she used to have Sean Cassidy. Same kind of deal.
I like this answer.
Marijuana plant. 1967.
Hey, yeah, I would. Yeah.
Okay. Oh, yeah. All right. Okay. Yeah, all right.
I like that answer.
All right. Cheer. Good.
All right. Let's see. What else do we got here?
Nips.
Oh, right.
Okay.
That's still Farrah Fawcett.
Yeah. Yes.
I did have Olivia Newton-John.
Okay, so this is from
Newton John, yeah.
Oh, yes. So this is from Istanbul. We've got the posters were of Einstein and Liz Taylor. It is very highbrow. I'm very impressed.
Yeah, that's
really
is.
Good. Yeah.
What else we got?
I just hope that it's the one of Einstein with his tongue sticking out.
Alyssa Milano, for sure.
Ooh, yeah, Alyssa Milano was a good one. That's a very good one. Yeah, for sure.
I also, though, had a Free Willy movie poster.
Oh, was it like the
of him jumping over the over the rocks? Yes. And then I also had a big like save the whales from SeaWorld kind of poster that I also hung.
Uh-huh.
And then I also painted a giant killer whale on the back of my wall or the back
you
of my door.
You painted it yourself?
I did. Yeah,
my mom's parents let you do that.
Yeah, they still have it.
Do they really?
Yeah,
that's amazing. Go
yeah,
mom.
The door itself. Yeah.
Uh oh. And oh, my mom said that she had the Beach Boys and Herman's Hermits.
Oh, nice.
Yes. That's the I am Henry the Eighth. I am. That's Herman's.
Who's Nancy talking to here?
Oh, Nancy said, oh, that I also had a Ricky Martin poster.
Oh, yeah.
Ricky Martin's actually coming to the Amway here in Orlando not too long from now Enrique Iglesias.
Oh, that'd be fun.
Yes, it's going to be a spicy night down at the Amway.
Mom says the Beatles. She had the Beatles.
Oh,
on
the
her
Beatles.
Wall.
Yeah, that's good. That's good. And then Kelly had all the whale posters.
Yeah,
ah,
the same poster
with
my best friend
Kelly.
Yeah.
Okay, that's fair. Yeah, cool. Totally.
All
right, that's good.
Very good. That was fun. Yeah.
Question number two.
Finish this sentence.
Okay.
Too much is never enough of blank.
I didn't think about it at all. I don't even know what I would say, but I don't know what I would have said, but I said cake.
I'm going to say Capiroskas.
Oh, yeah. See, that's a good one. Okay. So, Mark.
Too my gosh, I have too many of those. I don't know what answers will come out of my mouth. see, this is the hard part.
No, you're not supposed to think.
Too much of love.
See, that's a good answer. I'm glad it was genuine.
Too much is never enough.
Oh, that's a thank you, Dawn.
That is very nice. Sean's hugs.
Oh, pizza's
oh, that's so true. That's lovely. One. Ooh, Brian, chocolate. So if you go up one again, we've got that Brian said
pizza.
This is a man after my own heart, where apparently all I can think about is cake. Yeah. I don't even know where the cake thing came from. I don't even love cake. Apparently I do.
Just the first thing that came into your mind.
Oh,
cheesecake. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Ooh. Linda,
sorry.
Never enough kindness.
Yeah.
Oh,
Mrs.
That's so
Claus
good.
Would be very happy with that answer.
That's very good. It's a very good answer. That's a great answer.
Dry roasted peanuts. I do love a good dry roasted peanut.
Dry roasted peanuts. Ooh, I would never thought of
cheese.
That. But yeah, very well.
It's another one that I do not stop.
Cheese.
Yeah, cheese.
Yes.
And you know what goes well with cheese? A little wine.
Red wine. Please. And someone said chocolate. I don't know who it was.
I did see chocolate.
Oh, Linda up there said chocolate. Hey, that's very sweet. Who are we related
nice
to?
Answer.
Oh, it was Brian. Oh, that's lovely. Okay, cool.
And Kathy says,
loving pets. Oh, that's true. Yeah. That's true.
Amen. I would have my house full if I could.
You already do have your house full if you can. Okay. All right. So that's good. Question number three.
This is our final question of getting to know you.
Okay.
Do you prefer an escape room or a haunted house?
What kind of question is that? Okay.
Well, do you prefer to figure your way out or do you just like to get scared?
Oh, see, I've never done an escape room, so I wouldn't know. Okay, Mark's got an answer. I can feel it.
I'm a haunted house guy.
Me too.
Are you really?
Me too.
Haunted. I used to go with Donna Lynn Champlin and her group out to the Headless Horseman haunted hayride outside New York, and it was the most amazing evenings.
Okay.
Just saying.
Okay, that's good. That's good.
Yeah.
And you're also
out and I'm on the floor. So done. So.
Yeah. And you also work like Halloween Horror Nights every year, which is like the ultimate haunted house of haunted houses in the world.
That's probably why I will say when I was younger, I did not like haunted houses, but it's not until I started working, on the training side of them that I really gained an appreciation for what they can do. Well, and what they can do creatively really is what it is. You know, when you're walking through at least at Universal haunted houses, it's like walking through a show. I mean,
I'm sure.
And it's incredible. Like walking in the movie.
know. Well, the fact that I have never done either one. Well, guess what?
You're going to Halloween Horror Nights this year.
I don't think so.
And we're going to film the whole thing and we'll share it.
Not cool. I do not like to be scared. I don't watch horror movies. Like, none of this sounds like a good idea to me. I feel like the girls always die. Like, we're never in good shape at the end of these things.
It's
so
very true.
I guess it would be escape room. If that's like thinking one, I guess that's the one that I want to be in.
Yeah, that's the one where you're like, you got to like find
like strategy and stuff. Yeah, I'd probably like that. We actually have one here in town. I should go.
There's quite a few actually.
Yeah, if you want to do some kind of like Halloween Horror Nights event thing, that'll be the only time you'll ever get me there.
I think, well, if that's, yeah, I mean, I'm gonna try to make it happen, everybody. We're gonna try to get her. We're gonna have her wear one of those cameras.
Oh my god, catches, like a body cam. Yes. It's not gonna be pretty. Nobody wants to see that.
That catches her all reaction. So we got okay. Linda saying haunted house, and another Linda saying escape room.
Yeah, I'm with you, Mom. Escape room. Yeah. Yeah, we've got haunted house, lots of haunted houses.
Ooh, oh, a labyrinth. I do, yeah.
I like, so wait a minute. I don't know if this is like an Istanbul translation. Like, is that a labyrinth?
Like a maze, right? You're like thinking
Like
a maze.
Yeah, but I'm saying like, is that more what an escape room would be in Istanbul?
Maybe.
I don't know. I'm asking.
I don't know. Yeah, I don't know.
It's a haunted hayride though.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, escape room. Haunted houses really scare me. I'm with you, Kathy. Like, I'm not into being scared. I think the woman is scary enough. We don't need to be scared. What were you saying, Mark? I just talked to you. I'm sorry.
No, I'm talking over you. What if it's a haunted house escape room, though?
Ooh. That might be a market that hasn't been tapped into yet.
Maybe that's what needs to happen next. Maybe you've got to, like, figure your way out of the scary clowns or whatever it is.
Yeah.
That sounds like
something's gonna happen this Halloween, everybody.
Oh Lordy, I can't even imagine what it'll be. Anyway, Mark,
that's all the time we have. Thanks, Mark. Grateful. Yes, thank you.
Thank you so much for being on today and for singing for us. You were so uplifting, and we're so grateful for you and your talent and your time, and that you took the chance to come hang out with us tonight and share with our people. We appreciate it.
Thank you for putting up with me and on this special Thursday evening.
Right, on Tax Thursday. You brought us a whole lot of love.
Thank you. Thank you all for joining us tonight, and I hope to see you all sometime soon.
We hope so too. Mark, thanks so much for being here. We'll see you soon.
Pleasure.
Bye-bye.
Oh, we really appreciate you taking the time to join us, whether it was watching us live or if you watched us later in the week. Thank you. And of course, thank you again to our special guest tonight, Mark Sanders.
We hope you guys have a great week, and we hope that you will join us on the Cordone and Kilgore Facebook and YouTube channels. We're taking next week off, but we will be back Monday, April 26th, when we will be coming to you live with Dave Croft and Reverend Cynthia Alice Anderson from the Experience of the Soul podcast channel. Thank you all so much for joining us, and enjoy the rest of your week and weekend.
It's weird to say week and weekend. We'll see you guys soon. We'll see you back on a Monday. We'll see you then.
Bye-bye.